Hello friends, the next topic in the series of game theory, the next method is approximation method. This method is also called iterative method. Why? Because this method does not give you the exact value of game, rather it gives you the approximate value, the range within which the value of game will lie. Even the strategies are also determined in this method, but still that are not that much reliable as we have done in the previous methods. So the suggestion is apply this method only and only when it has been specifically asked in the question. This method relies upon the past, that past is the best guide to determine the future. So we base our decisions on the basis of past. Another important point is apply this method whenever the game is of 3x3 size or more, or it is of 3x4, 3x5, you can apply this method. We generally apply some steps to apply the iterative method. We start with selecting the row which is the strongest one, which is the superior one, and out of that superior row we select the minimum column. Based upon that we select the column, and that column is added in the previous row that have been chosen. Like this we go on moving till 10 steps. Once we reach at 10 steps, then we find the value of game. Let us learn this method with the help of a practical question that will lead to more clarity. This is the practical question that we will solve with the help of approximation or iterative method. So, iterative method will be applied to calculate approximate value of game. So, the first step here is that you have to see for player A. Player A is going to choose the row which is the strongest row, the superior row. So, you have to just make sure which row is having the superior values. If I look at the first row, one value is negative, there is one zero as well. If I look at the second row, there is again a negative value. But if I look at the strategy third of player A, it seems to be the superior row. So you have to choose the row which seems to be the superior one. And what you will do is, you will take this row out and you will write down this row below. So my superior row is 1, 3, 8 and 2. As all the values are positive and it seems to be strongest among all the rows. Now in the second step, what you will do is, you will just observe this row that you have taken out and you will just select which one is the minimum element. So out of this row, minimum element is 1, you will put a circle over there. Now once you put a circle, in which column this circle has been put? In this column. So what you will do is, you will take this column now out. So I am taking this column out. So first step was, take the strongest row out, select the minimum element from that row, the element which has been chosen, take that column and take that column out. Now out of this column, take the maximum number, row wise minimum number, column wise maximum number. Take it in a circle. So this is the maximum number. Go inside this row, 5, 4, 2, minus 2. Earlier we have taken this row out. Now instead of taking this row out, we will add these elements in the row already taken out. So this is the row that has been chosen, 5 plus 1, 6, 4 plus 3, 7, 2 plus 8, 10, minus 2 plus 2, it will be 0. Now again, what we will do is, we will choose the minimum out of this row. This 0 is the minimum, keep it in a circle. Now go inside this column, values are 0, minus 2, 2, add this in the column that we have earlier taken out. 0 plus 2, it will be 2, minus 2 plus 5, it will be 3, 2 plus 1, it will be 3. Now column wise maximum we have to choose. Now you see a tie, 3 and 3. So we cannot take the first because circle has already been put in this. So you will be taking the other one. If there is a tie, in that case only, otherwise we would have taken the maximum. Here maximum is 3, 3. So here, which to be selected? If earlier a circle has been put in the particular row, do not select that, select the other one. Now this has been chosen. Now this row is chosen. This row's element will be added in the elements that we have already taken. So 6 plus 1, 7, 7 plus 3, 10, 10 plus 8, 18, 0 plus 2, it will be 2. Now again, we have to choose row wise minimum. So minimum is 2, select this column, add into this. 0, 2, 2, minus 2 plus 3, 1, 2 plus 3, 5. Again, we have to choose the maximum. Out of this, maximum is this 5. Again, go inside that row and add in the previous elements. So here values will be 7 plus 1, it will be 8, 10 plus 3, it will be 13, 18 plus 8, 26, 2 plus 2, 4. So 8, 13, 26 and 4. Which one is the minimum? This is the minimum, circle it out. Go inside this column, add here 0 plus 2, 2 minus 2 plus 1, it will be minus 1, 2 plus 5, it will be 7. So now again column wise maximum. So this one is the maximum. Go inside this row. Again add the elements here. 1 plus 8, it will be 9. 13 plus 3, 16. 26 plus 8, 34. 2 plus 4, 6. Row wise minimum. This one is the minimum. Again go inside this column. Add it here. 0 plus 2, 2 minus 2. Minus 1, it will be minus 3. 2 plus 7, it will be 9. Column wise maximum, this. So like this, you will keep on continuing. Now the question arises, till when we have to continue? Till 10 rows have been created. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows have been created. So we have to create 10 rows like that. So now I have chosen this 9. So choosing this 9, this row is chosen. So 9 plus 1, it is 10. 16 plus 3, 19. 8 plus 34, 42, 2 plus 6, 8. Row wise minimum. Again, this row is being chosen. So go inside this, add it here. It will be 2 minus 5 and 11. Now column wise maximum. Again, this is the maximum. Go inside this row. This row will be again added. So it will be 10 plus 1, 11. 19 plus 3, 22. It will be 50. And 10. Row wise minimum. This is the minimum. Again go inside this. Add it here. 2 plus 0, 0. Minus 7, 13. Maximum. Again this is 13. So again this row. Add it here. 12, 25, 58 and 12. Now see, we have to choose the minimum. So 12 and 12. Two are coming. So as I told you, if there is a tie, the circle that has already been done, don't take that. We will choose this first. So 12, 25, 58 and 12. So now this column has been chosen. It will be added here. 2 plus 0, 2, 5 plus minus 7, minus 2, 13 plus 1, 14. Now maximum out of this, again this, add it here. It will be 12 plus 1, 13, 25 plus 3, 28. It will be 66 and it will be 14. So values will be 13, 28, 66 and 14. So which one is the minimum? Of course, this is the minimum. Going inside this, first column is selected. So we will add in the first column. 2 plus 2, 4. 5 minus 2, 3, 15. Again, this is the maximum. Going inside this, 13 plus 1, 14. 28 plus 3, 31. It will be 74, then 16. So 14, 31, 74 and 16. So which one is the minimum? This 14 is the minimum. Going inside this, the values are 2, 5, 1. It will be 6, 8 and 16. So this is the maximum. Now just count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. From this side also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we have to make it 10. So after making it, what you have to do is you have to just write the approximate value of game and the approximate value of strategy. So first of all, let us write the approximate value of strategies. Probability that A, player A, will be choosing the first strategy. What you have to do is you have to count the circle. Just see, in the first row there is no circle. So probability that player A will be choosing first strategy is 0 by 10. 10 means total 10. Probability that player A will be choosing the second strategy. Player A and second strategy. How many circles are there? 1. So it will be 1 by 10. Probability that player A will be choosing the third strategy. What is the probability? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 out of 10. So this is how you will be counting the strategies. Now let us do this for player B. Probability that player B will be choosing the first strategy. How many circles are there? 1, 2, 3 and 4 circles are there. So choosing first strategy for B is 4 by 10.
In the second column, you can see there is no circle. So selecting the second strategy will be 0 by 10. In the third, again, there is no strategy. So you will be writing 0 by 10. And selecting the fourth strategy for B, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it will be 6 by 10. So like this, you have to write the strategies. Just count the circles. Now, what about the value of game? Value of game will also be in an approximation. So what you have to do is you have to observe the last circle. Last circle is in the solution. You have to see which is the last row. And in the last row, this item which has been circled, it is 14. So you will be writing 14 by 10. Out of 10, the first value has been chosen 14. It will be less than and equal to value of game, which will be less than and equal to, look at the column. Our last column was 6, 8 and 16, and which has been in circle? 16. So this is 16 by 10. So this is how you will be writing the value of game. The value of game which will be lying from 14 by 10 to 16 by 10. But there is no fixed value, there is approximate value of game. So this is how the approximation method will show the strategies as well as value of games.